Can science look like magic? You bet. You're about to learn a series of magic tricks that are based on scientific principles. You can perform these as magic tricks, or you can use them to demonstrate a scientific principle. Let's get started. This trick is based on Bernoulli's principle, which roughly states that the faster air or liquid flows, the less the pressure. The air surrounding the ball is at a low pressure, and the air surrounding the ball on the outside creates kind of a cone of high pressure, which keeps the ball in its little cone, and with the air coming from the air dryer, it floats in the air. Can you float a paperclip on water? Not doing very well. Let me show you how. Here's how you can make a paperclip float on water, a seemingly impossible task. You need two paperclips. Take one paperclip and bend it 90 degrees so it looks like this. Now you're ready to show your friends how to do this. Rest the second paperclip on it. Slowly descend into the water. And you've caused a paperclip to magically float in the water. But it's not magic. It's pure science. Normally, you can't float a solid metal object like a paperclip in water. But here, we gently place the paperclip into the water and we rely on surface tension, the ability for the water to cling to itself to actually hold up the paperclip. And that's the secret to this science magic trick. And don't forget, you can use this as a bar bet where you bet your friends that you can make a paperclip float on water. So you have them try and they will fail. And then you show them this technique because you know the secret behind water surface tension. Perform this trick just as I showed you here. It all works itself thanks to science. How does this work? Well, inside of the glass there's air, which is trapped inside of the glass, which is on top of the towel. So thus, when you turn the glass over, push it into the water, the air prevents the water from entering into the glass and getting the towel wet. Now, if you were to take this glass and tilt it to the side, then air would begin to escape and water would get in and the towel would get wet. So as long as you keep it inverted straight down inside of the water will not enter because of the air pressure and your towel will remain dry.